What's up guys, Sal here. So nearly a couple of years ago, Samsung and AMD announced a partnership on mobile GPU for Samsung's future mobile processors. We expected the Exynos 2100 will be the first processor to feature the first of the new GPUs, but that didn't happen. We instead got information that we'll only see the AMD Radeon graphics on Exynos chips as soon as 2022 or early 2023. But it seems like we don't have to wait until next year to see the new GPU on Samsung phones. According to Ice Universe, it will happen as soon as the second half of this year. He says, and I quote, Exynos 2100 is just the beginning. This year's Exynos series will be very exciting, and you'll also see what you want to see. Now, it's a cryptic tweak that doesn't specifically say that we're going to see AMD GPU on this year's Samsung phones, but Ice Universe replied to a separate tweet saying that you don't have to wait until next year. There are currently plans to launch the Radeon graphics on Samsung phones as soon as this year. Interestingly, according to this tipster who has a mixed track record, AMD helped Samsung to fine-tune the CPU and GPU of the Exynos 2100 that we'll see on the Galaxy S21. Now, we don't know how true that is, but certainly, according to benchmarks, the Exynos 2100 is outperforming the Snapdragon 888 by a margin. The Exynos team has uploaded another teaser of the Exynos 2100, the launch event of which is happening on January 12th. This is the first time in years that Samsung is keeping a dedicated event for its flagship SoC, which further confirms that Samsung is pretty confident in their new SoC, and AMD might have provided some input to make the Exynos great again. Anyway, the new AMD GPU is currently referred to as RDNA Exynos, and it has surfaced on Geekbench almost 8 months ago. You can see the difference in performance compared to Adreno 650 of the Snapdragon 865. The scores are almost 3 times higher on the RDNA Exynos. Now, if you live in the United States and Canada and disappointed that you won't get to use the AMD GPU in the upcoming Samsung flagships, then fret not, because eventually Samsung will use Exynos chipsets all over the world, including the United States, according to Ice Universe. We don't know when that's gonna happen, but will happen at some point. If you're disappointed with the bland color options of the Galaxy S21 Ultra, then here's some good news for you. Samsung is gonna launch the S21 Ultra with 3 more colors, bronze, blue, and titanium. Galaxy S21 Plus will also be available in red and pink gold. But the thing is, these colors will not be available at launch. According to Ross Young, we won't be able to see these colors until April. And also, Samsung will make it in limited quantities. It seems 2021 is the year we're gonna see a huge downfall of Huawei, kind of like Nokia's back in 2012. According to research firm TrendForce, Huawei will drop from its 3rd place finish at the end of 2020 to 7th place this year. That's a rather large fall for a company that at some point became the top smartphone manufacturer in the world, beating Samsung in 2020. The top 5 smartphone manufacturer this year, according to this research firm, could be Samsung, Apple, Xiaomi, Oppo, and Vivo. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.